There is no defense against a spire attack. By the time you see them in the air, it's already too late. After impact, the spires release swarms of crawlers. Literally thousands of them can come from a single spire. Whole cities have been infected in minutes. After the crawlers have done their work, the Chimera send in carriers to collect the dormant victims. The role of the carriers is to transport infected humans to conversion centers. It's at these locations that the Chimeran creatures are born. Hale was brought to a conversion center in the town of Grimsby. My convoy team and I were imprisoned at the same location. We had been captured uninfected, so we were put in makeshift pens until they could infect us.
Sergeant Hale, First Rangers.
An American? We thought the Chimera stopped all of you in York.
Chimera?
Those creatures. Oh, you jammed it. I'm sorry, Hale. Looks like you'll have to find your own way out. I'll be in touch. Frequency 77.6. It was strange enough that a lone American soldier was walking around a Chimeran conversion center, but it was his eyes that were most disturbing. They showed unmistakable Chimeran traits. It was subtle, but it was there. Whoever Nathan Hale was, he wasn't entirely human.
Thank you.
The conversion center was built on top of an old fish cannery. Networks of tubes transported the bodies from one stage of conversion to another. Once humans are infected by the Chimeran virus, they fall into a coma. The virus begins changing their bodies from the inside out, eventually turning them into one of the Chimeran creatures. The conversion centers simply speed up the process. During the second phase of the conversion process, the humans are wrapped in cocoons. This accelerates the final stages of the conversion. What emerges from the cocoon is determined by the strain of the virus. Each Chimeran creature is created by a separate strain. What we call hybrids, the ones that most closely resemble humans, have the shortest gestation period. The more beastly creatures take months to create and are made from multiple human bodies. final stage of the Chimeran conversion process is known as the birthing chamber. The cocoons are opened and new Chimera are born. In the case of hybrids, a cooling apparatus is fused into their bodies. The Chimeran metabolism is roughly 12 times that of humans. This results in remarkable healing abilities, but also raises their body temperatures significantly. Without the cooling apparatus, the hybrids would overheat and die.